2015. Welcome, everybody. Please silence or shut off your cell phones at this time. And join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So on our agenda, we do have the addition of a mineral rights request. We have deletions of ordinance number 112 revision that was taken care of yesterday. And the other one that we've done yesterday isn't on here anyways. That was from the gym. That was for action yesterday. Have I missed anything?
Not that I'm aware of.
All right. So we'll move right in. 10 o'clock, public comment. Any public comment at this time?
Glad to be back.
We're glad that you're here.
Yep.
So, with there being no public comment at this time, we'll move right on down our agenda. Our first non-timed item is Town of Lakeview Revocable Consent to Annexation Request. Town Manager Ray Sims was here yesterday. We had quite a lengthy discussion about the roads that they'd like to consider taking in on their annexation and the parcels. For clarification, the information we have, the parcels on block 353 up on E Street, that one is not part of this annexation. We want to take it off. I guess we better look at the consent if it's listed on there. I don't believe it is. But block 353, you see it on there, Commissioner?
No, I don't, but just hang on just a second.
So looking on the irrevocable consent annexation, I don't see it listed on there, so it should be good.
Okay.
So I'll make a motion to accept the irrevocable consent annexation presented from the Town of Lakeview to Lake County. Just for clarification, that excludes from the map that's attached block 353 as presented. I don't know. Just for clarification.
Okay. Second.
Motion's been made and seconded. Further discussion? What this does is start a one-year time frame for the town to go through their ordinance process to be able to bring these properties into the annex part of the Lakeview area. This is all an urban growth boundary, which is for future growth, and it's normal for those areas to be annexed in as they're developed or be water and sewer. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. And it is 5 minutes after 10. We will officially open up a public hearing on ordinance 111 at 5 minutes after 10. This ordinance is in the matter of the donation of surplus property. This is the second hearing on this ordinance. So at this time, if there's any testimony in favor or against this, we would take that at this time. And so we'll leave that hearing open for a while. Nothing at this time. Next item, Town of Lakeview MOU/Schmidt Museum support. We had discussion yesterday on this Schmidt Museum. We're working forward to try to acquire that as county ownership, operated and managed by Lake County Museum Board. That decision went forward yesterday through our negotiations with Red Rock Biofuels and the Town of Lakeview, and the split of the community service fee was negotiated for when Red Rock does start paying the community service fee, for them to do an MOU with the county and support the museum by $10,000 a year for the 15 years. And so this would be to accept the draft MOU to send back to the town, but then do the final approval.
Did you say 15 or 10?
15 years.
Oh, 15, okay.
$10,000 for 15 years, if I misstated that.
No, I probably just missed her.
Bless you.
Bless you. I'm sorry. I was feeling that cool letter.
Yeah, what's with that?
I feel it too.
Yeah.
I think it's the door opener is drafted through.
Thank you.
So, would entertain a motion?
I'll make a motion, we accept the town of Lakeview's MOU as presented.
I'll second the motion. Motion's been made and seconded to accept the MOU between Lake County and the town as presented. Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, motion carries.
This is only the draft, so I'll have to get the original from the town.
Yep, they'll have to present to their board.
I'll let Ray know.
And we just have to sign it. Next item, Double Eagle Loan Extension. Our treasurer came before us yesterday on this extension. Double Eagle Mining Company has a loan through our community development loan program. They have not missed a payment, they've been current for over half of their time from July of 2013 till now. There has become a need to extend this by 3 months to allow them to be able to get some of the products and other things to market. And so it's pretty straightforward. Double Eagle has been a great recipient of loan.
Yep.
Done very good on the payments.
I'll make a motion that we approve the Double Eagle loan extension request.
I'll second the motion. Motion's been made and seconded. Further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, motion carries. Mr. Dave Berman, yesterday we tabled this till today. If you come up, this is draft easement for access and utilities T-Mobile. So,
would you want to be in your draft pick?
You have 30 seconds to convince us to do this. If not, we'll table it for another year.
Would you want to be in your draft pick?
Yeah.
The grant easement is for T-Mobile. They want to put it on American Tower, which is old Verizon Tower. I looked in the agreement contract. American or Verizon can do what they do, or they can allow T-Mobile to put their site or their equipment on American Tower. So that's basically what it is an easement for Lake County to give T-Mobile an easement to get to American Tower's tower. And then on the side, there's a side letter about a $500 one-time fee. They pay us $500 for the grant easement to get to.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
To get to the tower so they can have, we can't, when they put this, if we allow this easement, we can't build on top of this easement, another tower, but we wouldn't anyway. I mean, I don't see how that we could do that anymore. Or not that we couldn't do it, but it's in a line where we wouldn't put a tower.
Is Verizon doing a subcontract request for this company?
Yes.
On our tower, on our
land? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. But all I know is in the agreement with American Tower, they can allow any improvements on their tower or the tenant, because there's a tenant, they can do. In the agreement, they can do this with T-Mobile's equipment on there.
So why are they willing to pay us $500?
I can't answer that. I don't know.
Commissioner, can I see your letter? I found it kind of strange.
How wide is this easement? That's the only thing I had never thought about asking that.
They will need to do on the letter request and the amount and the date. I don't know if yours has the same thing, but Commissioner Winters shows it, and so does mine. It says Dear Dan Cham, which I'm not gonna be the one signing it.
Right, this is the one that you forwarded over to me. They contacted you, and then you forwarded it over to me.
This is an email?
Yeah, this is their agreement. They contacted you first, and then you forwarded everything over to me.
No, what I mean is I forwarded an email to you.
Referring to me, but the letter still said Dan Cham.
Okay.
So by contract, I mean, this is all normal operations. The only flag that sort of came up is through your discussion there is however wide this easement is limits.
Well, the easement is just around.
Any kind of development there at all, so.
It doesn't really give spec, but in here, it's for wiring and stuff to get there, so how wide that is.
But the legal description just talks, part of section 11, township 3920, abbreviated legal. I guess we need to make sure that it's a very narrow easement. It's not like the whole road ends up there in case we ever have to put another easement through there, or if we need to do any construction or anything like that, is my only concern. Because whenever it's general like that, we give them an easement, and we can't construct. We've seen that work and everything it says here. We could accidentally be into, they could take a big area, limit other potential development up there, I guess is my concern.
Well, I'll get a hold of them and.
Sorry, I didn't catch that until our conversation.
Honestly, I think it's this wide of an easement, to be honest with you, around electrical wire. But I'll find out. I'll just give them a call and say what we're looking at.
By description, because they refer to Exhibit A, it says Section 11, northwest quarter, which would be 160 of the northwest quarter of the northeast quarter. So it's a, I don't know what it is. I mean, that's probably as far down as they can get. It's less than 10 acres, but
that's a lot of ground like that.
Yeah. If we can get that pinned down or.
And I think we can approve it contingent upon Dave making sure that the easement is the narrowest and the most appropriate place for future development.
And with that, Dave, when you talk to him, I agree with that. Can you have him change that to, you're probably the one that's going to sign this.
They probably had your name there at the time. It was probably chair or something. The reason why the email.
I don't even remember the email that Dave does, so yeah. I just send him stuff. So I'll make a motion that we do approve this easement request contingent upon those things that have been discussed, even clarified.
Second motion. Motion's been made and seconded to approve the request contingent upon Dave come to agreement on the width of the easement. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Long-term enterprise zone agreement, resolution 1512-16. This is the resolution that was tabled to come forward on Red Rock.
I'm sorry, but Dave sat there. I don't know if you're thinking it through and then they get something else you want.
Well, I was going to kind of give you an update. Well, if you started, I can.
No, I'm just trying to buzz right on.
There you go. Why wouldn't
so, so we will go back. Mr. Merwin.
We don't get it here and talk very often, so let's.
Well, I just, it's been kind of sparse, but communication, but I just wanted to bring it to you guys and then you guys already know.
I will.
Well, we got awarded the grant for the ski hill. I haven't brought that. So we got the grant for a well, water rights in the RV space and tent sites up at the ski hill.
Outstanding, Dave.
Yes.
So
very good.
Yeah. I just wanted to put that out there. So.
No, that's great. So deal looks like. It's talking to some of the skiers yesterday, it sounds like.
I heard yesterday they were gonna try to open that.
Oh, are they?
Only if they have water.
Yeah.
But they don't.
They don't have water?
They don't.
Oh, we're working on that. All right, thank you.
All right, sorry about that.
That's all right.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Yeah. Denise, we're gonna tell Dave.
I'll see that to us with the actual change of forms.
Okay.
Okay, going back to resolution number 1512-16, in the matter of authorizing Lake County to execute a long-term rural enterprise zone agreement for Red Rock Biofuels LLC. This was tabled at our joint meeting with the town. Just normal operating procedures to do that until now. As was waiting on the MOU and the consideration on the community service fees. So this is just doing the final stage of approval of that.
So when are we gonna negotiate this split? We have a town council member here, so.
Probably do that right now.
It's okay, Jen.
If you were asleep at the meeting, I worked very hard to try to get both boards to negotiate that, it would, no avail.
Would you like me to bring my stun gun in?
I'm gonna take off my.
I thought you were gonna cover your head.
I'm gonna take off my Lakeview jacket there.
So I'll make a motion. Go ahead.
I'll make a motion to accept resolution number 15-12-16, in the matter of authorizing Lake County to execute a long-term rural enterprise zone agreement with Red Rock Biofuels LLC.
I'll second that.
Motion's been made and seconded. Any further discussion?
Yeah, can we strike some of those comments that one of the commissioners made?
There are many types of them.
I do have.
Can you edit?
Yeah, I do have a comment, and Darwin's here, and Ginger's here as well, the commissioner. Once again, thank you for all the blood, sweat, and tears, the time, the effort. I know it was a long, drawn-out process, and appreciate everybody's hard work on that, these kind of things. Under the best of circumstances aren't simple to do, and the end result, which is what I believe you and our other members of the county did an excellent job of, is keeping our eye on the target, and that is the company getting cited here and all of the multiple benefits that we're gonna receive from having a company located here like you. Thank you.
Thank you. We're a team.
Yep.
All in favor? Aye?
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you. Before we move to our next one, I'm gonna go back to our ordinance hearing, 111. Is there any public comment on ordinance 111 at this time? If not, we will close that hearing at 10:18. And we will, we can go ahead and act on that at this point. We've ran two hearings on ordinance 111. There has been no public testimony on it either hearing. There's been no written or phoned-in testimony that I'm aware of. And what this ordinance will do is allow the county, in the matter of donation of surplus county property, we're able to donate that to nonprofit organizations, other agencies, government agencies, but also if it has no more than $1,500 value. So.
Yeah, long overdue. This cleans up our process on how this can happen.
Yeah, for sure. Yep, streamlines it, makes it fast.
Yeah. I'll make a motion that we approve ordinance number 111-1.
I'll second the motion. Motion's been made and seconded in the matter of donation of surplus property to approve ordinance number 111. Further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye, motion carries. Lateral opportunity grant, RFQ van purchase award. Denise, Were you able to get the information?
I have no additional information, so if we can carry that forward.
All right.
I will double check with ODOT to see what timeline. I just need, I haven't received confirmation back on that yet either. So if we have to hold special session, I'll be in touch.
Okay.
At this time, I have nothing.
Carry that forward to the next meeting, awaiting the appropriate information. Moving down to our addition mental rights request, Mr. Johnson is here, planning director. Quite a discussion yesterday on this. Further discussion at 5 last night. And emails at 5:45 or whatever, so give us an update for wrap.
Yep, and at 9:25 this morning, you may have got back and said everything works good, so. Our discussion yesterday should have covered it. I've given you an updated order that has just the three properties that have no significant total value to them, of which this actually allows us to get into the process of setting up a hearing that will be at least 6 weeks out, and I'll have to publish 4 consecutive weeks prior to that hearing, the legal description, and just the notice of the hearing, so.
So reading this, Darwin, and the value of these three properties, the mineral, relinquishing the mineral rights on these three pieces of property have a value. Maybe I didn't catch it, but it's not stated in the hearing.
Yeah, it's not stated in the order itself. Kind of left that blank so that we can have further discussion. We haven't really had a whole lot of discussion. I did, after talking with you yesterday afternoon and then putting this email together, I did give a formal, recommendation of a minimum value that I thought would be best appropriate, of $10 an acre. Also wrote that no less than $100 be charged for other future requests that we may receive. We could probably establish that by policy, but just at this point, it's my recommendation. But the statute allows us to charge a minimum fee on the actual value of the property being transferred, the mineral rights itself, aside from all the actual costs that we can, get reimbursed for all legal work, any time spent on this. And I'm aware of at least my opinion and recommendation to you guys. It had always been thought of by them, at least, that there would be no fee charge possibly if it came back as no value to the mineral rights on those properties. But certainly in the public's best interest, I think it's appropriate that we get at least something. And then knowing that this kind of sets a precedence moving forward, it'd be nice to make sure that we at least put some minimum value that can be set by the county to, for future requests.
Well, Darwin, I think that point that you're making is a good one. We've had discussions on it. We're not geologists. We did hire someone on behalf of the company to go out and review, but until people actually would go out and review and explore and do this and that, I would refer to it as known value as opposed to no value.
Exactly.
And I think that would be reason enough, especially with the interest in getting those mineral rights so significant. It has a value in itself just by transferring them.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It's certainly a value to them,
yeah,
as a company, because they want to develop these solar projects, but it supposedly has made it more difficult for the financing to be approved by having this incumbency on the table.
Yeah.
So looking at this, Darwin, those are the Crow Run, Black Cap 2, Fremont, and Lost Forest are the three that...
The report states that are okay. Little or no value. Yeah.
I just want to make sure that was correct and that it was, which is difficult. So should the motion include the $10 per acre cost for this order to go forward?
The order itself at this point is just declaring our intent to purchase or to convey them. So at the hearing, we can give the final, but I know that Obsidian does want kind of some assurances moving forward that we're not going to certainly not be above that price. But yeah, it's up to you guys. It's ultimately your guys' decision on what value you want to put to.
Would this be a case of updating the fee schedule for different things? Because we don't have that on there.
Well, Yes, yes, and for discussion, Darwin needs to put together the policy within the planning department on the mineral site. I think it's going to, Dan, it's going to be almost case by case that we're going to be looking at it. Some of them, if we just do $10 per acre and it's for everything, it might not be exactly the appropriate amount. They're different. There is a value to relinquish those, as you say, and so I haven't really figured that out. Darwin and I had some of that discussion yesterday, but it needs to be sort of case by case, so I think he's going to work on some of that and present to us.
Yeah, I'd like to, you know, my opinion is I'd rather not give up our mineral rights, since as a public body, I think it's not usually in our best interest. And obviously, the state statute allows us to go through a process and do the investigative work with the geologist to find out if there's value. It is clear that you know, we can set it, that we can fix a minimum value to these after entering into an order. So, we're entering into an order first, but then we'd enter into an order after we hold the hearing that it will actually sell the properties or go transfer those individuals' rights over. Harney County was the only example. I've said this a few times, that their minimum fee that they set on any parcel, no size requirements or anything like that, is $300. And so, with a larger project like this, I thought it would make more sense to kind of go with an average, per acreage cost.
I think we get through this one, and I think the price is appropriate for now, but I think Darwin's going to probably check quite a bit across the state. And it's sort of all over the board, right?
Yeah, it is. And most don't even give up the mineral rights ever in any circumstances. They're just, sorry, that's not something we're
doing. Well, our mineral rights just become more valuable with the BLM and the record of decision that's coming down. Honestly. Mm-hmm.
So,
and I agree
with that. As for putting this into our fee schedule, it's one of these ORSs that apparently we can apply directly. It's probably how most counties apply the rule when it's such on a limited basis. But I'll be glad to put a policy forward, and if we want to talk at that time, we have that discussion on sentiment value. But a case-by-case basis is kind of where I think we might want to lean towards, and that's why I would just assume we leave it out off the fee schedule, but recognizing that it's
given that
it is ORS language that we can apply.
Yeah.
Okay, so for today, we can do the order, leave off the $10 per acre. You've already talked with the investor that that's the intent that you will propose to the Board of Commissioners at the appropriate time, unless there's extenuating reasons why it would be different than the day.
And I will follow up and after this, letting them know that the order's been approved to move forward on the noticing and setting the hearing date for the 3rd of February, that first Wednesday of February at 10:10 here in this room. But also that I have given you the formal recommendation of $10.
Is that a hearing, a planning commission hearing, or board?
No, it's a board. It's a board for the hearing, yeah. Which will be followed by the deeds, but I'll have presented or prepared at that time.
Okay. So I'll make a motion to approve order number 15-12-16 in the matter of declaring the intent to convey from reserve or accepted mineral rights of the county.
I'll second that.
Motion has been made and seconded. Further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carried. Thank you, Darwin.
Thanks, sir.
If I can give you a quick update. I don't have great news like Dave had about the grant. Up on the map, that was glad to see that happen. We did get a second letter, or another letter for Planning Commission member, Wes Davis, who grew up on the Roaring Springs Ranch in Harney County. His dad, Stacy, is a Planning Commission member on the Harney County Planning Commission. He is currently running the Farland Ranch operating now. What's here in town for the link out there. And so hopefully, I'm gonna get back to the planning commission and have a recommendation. Bylaws don't state that it has to be actually recommended in the planning commission meeting, so I'm gonna try to just get a poll them and get, you know, their vote kind of on that. Outside that meeting, but then have the recommendation for you guys at your general meeting so that Wes can start that first planning commission meeting, just January 19th. And we've got another solar application that's in the works for going to the site, so.
Oh.
And it'd be nice to have, Ginger's here and she's also our newest planning commissioner. So we could have a full board, which we haven't had for a whole year, so. So hopefully I'll have that for January.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Meeting minutes, we have three sets of meeting minutes. November 3rd, November 4th, and November 24th.
Commissioner Shanley, were you able to review the 24th that was yesterday?
Last night.
Okay.
With my phone sideways in my chair.
Cool. Just wanna make sure.
Oh, yeah. You were pretty neat.
I edited.
Yes, you did.
I'll move to approve November 3rd, November 4th, and November 24th minutes as presented.
I'll second it.
Motion's been made and seconded. Any further discussion? Denise, very good job on doing the minutes and capturing the meeting on the 24th. Thank you very much.
Yes.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, motion carries. Then Department of Legal updates, none for today, executive session, none for today. Have I missed anything?
Yep. I can tell you till later.
Okay. We will adjourn at 10:32.